Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to Morning Tales for July 26th, 2019. So today we are going to cover Morning Tales for July 26th. I hope you've already seen the Morning Tales for July 25th. If you have not, please go back to the previous video and watch Morning Tales for July 25th as well, and the older ones as well. You can also watch. So first of all, let me tell you that today, like yesterday, we are not going to cover only the current affairs, but we are also going to cover certain questions from the static portion, because the exam is around the corner. So it's very important that we cover the static portion as well regularly, and as pointed out by a student, that covering the static portion is very important, and he wanted to revise. So I thought let's start covering the static portion as well. Okay, so today we are going to cover the static portion as well, along with the current affairs that we are going to cover in any case. Okay, so that is something that I wanted to tell you. Okay, so let us start with the session. The first question is, what is India's position in the Global Innovation Index 2019? India's position in the Global Innovation Index 2019, that is the question. The answer to this question, if you know, then please provide me the answer in the comment section below. It's a very important news, because these indices are released every year, and some of the other questions always come from these areas. Okay, the answer to this question is D, 52nd position. India has jumped 5 places from 57 to 52nd position this year. Okay, and who releases GII? Global Innovation Index is released annually by Cornell, INSEAD and WIPO. So three organizations: WIPO, Cornell and INSEAD, they together release the Global Innovation Index. Okay, second question from today. Second question, the question is, which country has developed Sonali, an alternative method to replace plastic with jute bags that look like plastic? I think it's a very good thing that or a remarkable thing, a remarkable development or innovation that Bangladesh has come. So the answer to this question is Bangladesh, and what they've done is, they're the second largest producer of jute after India. India is the first largest or the largest producer of jute, and they have developed a technology through which a plastic looking bag can be developed from jute, which looks completely like plastic, but works like jute. So it is biodegradable and completely biodegradable and environment friendly. Okay, and it is expected to be out very, very soon in the market, expected to replace plastic. This is something that India should have done, rather than hearing that Bangladesh has done it. But never mind, Bangladesh has done it, so India can mimic it and can make money out of it, because it is the largest producer of jute in the entire world. The third question, which is the first state to pass the 75% reservation bill in private jobs for local youth? Now, why is this the first state? You must be thinking, Tamil Nadu also has 69% reservation in jobs. But why this is the first state? This is the first state because here jobs are going to be reserved in the private sector as well. So whether or not an industry is taking any financial or any other kind of help or funding from the state, it is also bound by this law, and it has to reserve 75% jobs for local youth. If that local youth does not have the skills, then the industry or the company is required to train the local youth instead of hiring people from outside. So the answer is Andhra Pradesh, the first state in the country to have passed 75% reservation bill in private jobs. That is something that's very important here. A lot of people are missing it out in current affairs that they're covering. Okay, now next question is, recently an interministerial committee has presented the draft banning of cryptocurrency and regulation of official digital currency bill 2019 to Ministry of Finance. The head of the committee, the answer is D, Subhash Chandra Garg. Subhash Chandra Garg is the head of the committee. Now why is this important? Number one, cryptocurrency is not yet banned in India. It is regulated strictly by RBI, but not yet banned in India. So RBI regulates it and tries to control its movement. Like banks are not allowed to invest in cryptocurrencies, things like that. But there is no blanket ban on cryptocurrency as of now. And this particular bill, if passed, is expecting or is proposing to ban cryptocurrencies completely from the country. Okay, because they cannot be controlled by the government or by the RBI. The next question is, who is the writer of Chandrasekhar, the last icon of ideological politics? A very factual question, and it is important just for the simple reason that the book has been released by the Prime Minister yesterday. And the answer to this question is Harivansh. Harivansh and Ravi Dutt Bajpai, these are the two writers of Chandrasekhar, the last icon of ideological politics. Where will BRICS Summit 2019 be held? 2019 BRICS Summit, it is the 11th BRICS Summit. Okay. And who are the members of BRICS? Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa. These are the five members of BRICS. The answer to this question is Brazil. This time it is going to be held in Brazil. Okay. So that's all for this particular question. Although one more important news here is, or one important information here is that Prime Minister Modi has provided a five-step solution to the world, de-development or to the problems in the world, and he tries to cover things starting from protectionism, which is affecting economic growth, to skill development in the entire world and skill movement in the world, because that is very important for India given India's population. And he's also talked about fighting terrorism, which is an important Indian concern in every global arena. And these are the kinds of things that he's talked about. He's talked about New Development Bank's role in development in BRICS area. So he's talked basically about finances. Okay, so these are the kinds of things that he's talked about in BRICS and given a 5-point solution to the world problems. The next question is, how many countries are presently member of International Monetary Fund? So International Monetary Fund, if you don't know, was established in 1944, and it has 189, total of 189 members. It was established in 1944. Started in 1944, some say 1945, some say 1944. The website also is confused about it. Let's not make a big deal out of it. But established in 1940s, the primary purpose was stability of international monetary system, because the exchange rate and the monetary system was in shambles after the Depression and the Second World War. So IMF came up, created as an organization. The purpose, international monetary system and international financial system should be stable. Therefore, so that another depression and another war does not happen. Okay, that is the primary purpose of IMF. SDR is the currency, or is the international reserve asset, not a currency. International reserve assets, special drawing rights, are created by IMF and issued by IMF to its member countries. So the answer is 189. Where is the headquarter of SAARC located? Headquarter of SAARC. What is the full form of SAARC? If you don't know, please provide me, go through it and provide me the full form of SAARC in the comment section below. I believe all of you must be aware about it. There are eight member countries. Students might be confused about out here as to which all countries are members of SAARC. And headquarter of SAARC located in Nepal. Located where? Located in Nepal. When was SAARC created? SAARC was created in Dhaka in the year 1985. So it was created in Bangladesh, but the headquarters are not located in Bangladesh. Okay, the secretariat is located in Kathmandu in Nepal. The purpose of SAARC, the purpose is economic and regional integration and development. Okay. Headquarter of Exim Bank, the last question for today, another static question. The answer to this question is Mumbai. So Exim Bank headquarter is where? Mumbai. What is the purpose of Exim Bank and what is the full form of Exim Bank? XM, X is export and M is import. So Exim Bank, the primary purpose is development of export import capabilities in India. When was it created? Established in 1982. So please remember that, established in the year 1982. The primary purpose, development of export import activities in the country. Okay, so it helps various small and medium enterprises by partnering with these industries and companies and helping them in their export and import. So if a small and medium enterprise wants to import any technology or export any product or any technology, then the helps, whether financial or non-financial, are provided by Export Import Bank of India. Okay, so this is all for today's morning tales. I hope you liked it. Tomorrow I will be coming out with more morning tales. If you like this session, do not forget to subscribe to the channel. And all these current affairs are going to be available in Spotlight as well. So do download the Spotlight from the website. It's available for free for every student. The daily current affairs and daily quiz are also available on the website itself. So if you're preparing for RBI or SEBI, rather than going through, you know, a lot of areas or a lot of sections or a lot of websites, you can just come here. And because we are dedicatedly creating content when it comes to current affairs for RBI and SEBI only, so I believe this will be enough for you. You don't have to look anywhere else. Okay, so that's all for today's session. All the very best. Take care. Have a nice day.